probably what he'd want, for us to finish the mission. But I can't. It's hard enough taking a life, but letting one be taken, knowing there was something I could do about it? Not a chance. Might be I'm risking my life, risking all our lives to save an asshole. What else am I supposed to do? That asshole is my dad.
Speaking of which, it's the 21st century and you're still running around with only a tiny knife for protection? It's stupid. All right, Desmond. Game's over. Not now. Not now! Inya is just a robot! Yet! Get out!
What the hell was that?
Get out! Get out! Get out!
Now give me the apple.
You want it? Fine. Here it is.
Wait! No!
Hey, when this is all over, we should take a trip somewhere. Celebratory vacation.
Yeah. That sounds nice.
Now listen to you. Italy, Brazil, and the United States, all in the span of a few weeks. And you're complaining about not getting out enough?
Seriously, Sean?
No, not seriously. Are you mad? Trust me, no one wants time off more than I do, right? Do you have any idea how hard it is to crank those database entries out as fast as I do?
So, when this is over, and assuming it all works out, I was hoping I could, you know, come home.
I'd like nothing more.
I've been poking around a bit. Did you know there are machines down here that make, well, mana?
Wizard mana or biblical mana?
What do you think? Biblical, of course. The Greeks called it ambrosia. The Indians, amrit or soma. Most cultures around the world refer to a divine food, though I'd say its taste is anything but.
You ate something that came out of a 75,000-year-old machine?
Maybe the flavorizer broke.
Flavorizer? You've certainly got away with words, Rebecca.
Give me Lee! Surrender, and I will spare you.
Brave words from a man about to die.
You fare no better.
Even when your kind appears to triumph, still we rise again. And do you know why? It's because the Order is born of a realization. We require no creed, no indoctrination by desperate old men. All we need is that the world be as it is. And this is why the Templars will never be destroyed.
Don't think I have any intention of caressing your cheek and saying I was wrong. Still, I'm proud of you in a way. You've shown great conviction, strength, courage. All noble qualities. I should have killed you long ago.
We've got a problem. Haytham doesn't have the amulet anymore.
But the temple's still sending data. There must be more to this story.
Only one way to find out.
I will kill Charles Lee.
Can I help you? You know you can.
Pardon? Oh!
I do not like having my time wasted.
You think you mad, and this is why. Even those men you sought to save have turned their backs on you. Yet you fight. You resist. Why?
Because no one else will.
Long have we waited for you to return. You have done as we asked. You have succeeded.
No, I have failed. My people are gone. Chased out by those who I thought would protect them.
It is a trade, a sacrifice, and not in vain. For you have found it.
This?
Now you must hide it. Where none shall think to look, and then in time, what once was, shall be, again.
I do not understand.
Nor need you. Only do as we ask. Then, you may do as you wish.
But what of my people?
You have saved this place. As was your people's purpose, and that matters most.
It is not enough.
It will never be enough. You strive for that which does not exist. Still, you have made a difference, and you will do so again. Remember, you must hide the amulet where none might find it.
If you're hungry, have extra.
No, thank you.
Since they left, seems some fella from New York was granted the land by Congress.
What?
Seeing it happen more and more. Government says they don't take land that's already owned, but...
How could this have happened?
We're on our own now. No more merry English parts and labor, which means we gotta go at it ourselves. Gotta pay for it too. Selling land is quick and easy, not quite so nasty as taxes. And since some say they're what started the old war, ain't no rush to bring 'em back. clever men, these new leaders of ours. They know not to push it just yet. Too soon for taxes. Too British.
Thank you.
Be safe.
My father left those for me. Mother, father, I am sorry. I have failed you both. I made a promise to protect our people. I thought if I could stop the Templars, if I could keep the revolution free from their influence, that those I supported would do what was right. They did, I suppose, do what was right. What was right for them. As for you, Father, I thought I might unite us. That we would forget the past and forge a better future. In time, I believed you could be made to see the world as I did, to understand. But it was just a dream. This, too, I should have known. Were we not meant to live in peace, then? Is that it? Are we born to argue? To fight? So many voices, each demanding something else. It has been hard at times, but never harder than today. To see all I worked for, perverted, discarded, forgotten. You would say I have described the whole of history, Father. Are you smiling then? Hoping I might speak the words you long to hear? To validate you? To say that all along you were right? I will not. Even now, faced as I am with the truth of your cold words, I refuse, because I believe things can still change. I may never succeed. The assassins may struggle another 1,000 years in vain, but we will not stop. Compromise. That is what everyone has insisted upon. And so I have learned it, but differently than most, I think. I realize now that it will take time. That the road ahead is long and shrouded in darkness. It is a road that will not always take me where I wish to go, and I doubt I will live to see its end. But I will travel down it nonetheless. For at my side walks hope. In the face of all that insists I turn back, I carry on. This is my compromise.
I killed her, you know. I killed Lucy.
It was the apple, son. It was Juno.
I saw what she was. What would happen if I let her live? I could have stopped myself. I mean, there was a force there. But I didn't have to. I chose to. Whatever's on the other side of that door, it benefits Juno. We need to be careful.
How do we know what the hell they were doing down here?
They were working on a bunch of different solutions, but nothing worked. Just went from one to the next, and then... I don't know. They must have left at some point. After the end.
I wonder what the world would be like if they'd succeeded.
I'm more concerned about what it'll be like if we don't.
Yes. Come. Here, at last.
You know our story now. Of how we tried. Of how we failed. All our hopes extinguished. Save one. Your touch. A spark. A spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not touch the pedestal.
Minerva?
You! But how? You left!
You destroyed the device!
Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
Free her?
Juno dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machines to set her plans in motion. Divination through numbers. There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time. This was my focus. And so I built the eye to avert her treachery. We put a stop to it. And then we left. But first we called to you that you might try again. We thought it would be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinia and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place and finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries, and so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying!
Only touch the pedestal and the world will be saved. Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that so? Show him then.
But he will not understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world. Merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows. Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. You will inspire them to rebuild, to thrive once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man, frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. You will be remembered first as a hero, later as a legend, and in time, as a god. It is the cruelest fate to have written words that meant well and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again.
She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication. They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future, but its freedom?
What future? What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew? This world has known nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them, and you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it. But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
If you free her, you'll be destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't!
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and to die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us! We'll find another way!
There isn't time.
Son.
You know it's true. It's already started. I need to do this now. So go. Go!
Do you regret anything, Desmond? What's it like spending your whole life avoiding hard decisions?
Is Desmond worth all this trouble? You know, what is he? Is he the chosen one? Is that it? Little Jimmy special? Some bollocks like that?
I wish I'd been more patient with my parents. I wish I'd listened.
Thank you.
For what?
For making sense.
It's some sort of global aurora borealis. Never seen anything like this before. Eyewitnesses describe electrical storms and erratic displays of unusual weather. Residents are being asked to remain inside and wait for... Geological surveys are now reporting seismic activity throughout the Ring of Fire. Northeastern Canada is said to be experiencing the largest... on record. Satellites and transformers are failing as the flare increases in intensity. Worldwide and volcanic activity is being reported, but nothing approaching earlier levels. Obviously, it will be a while before experts are able to assess the full extent of the damage caused by today's events. But it appears the worst is behind us. We'll be sure to bring you more as this story develops.
It is done. The world is saved. You played your part well, Desmond. But now... now it's time that I played mine.
Better than the fucking Templars.
Don't you ever acquaint me to those bastards again. You hear me? You are nothing. A speck of dust.
Yes, Andarissa, the Quetzca!
Or you could just admit that you are wrong.
Oh, sir, please, you've killed two men. One more salesman than soldier.
Enjoy your victory, Commander. It will be the last I deliver you.
Then tell me, on whose watch did the Brotherhood fall? Whose inaction allowed the Templar Order to grow so large that it now controls an entire nation?
If I sought to dissuade you, it was because you knew nothing. If I was reluctant to contribute, it was because you were naive. 1,000 times you would have died and taken God knows how many with you. Let me tell you something, Connor. Life is not a fairy tale, and there are no happy endings.
No. Not when men like you are left in charge.
I'm actually curious to know what your mother might have said about me. I've always wondered what life might have been like. She and I stayed together. How is she, by the way?
Dead. Murdered.
What? I'm sorry to hear that.
Oh, you're sorry? I found my mother burning alive. I'll never forget her face as she sent me away.
Charles Lee is responsible for her death by your order.
And you're sorry.
Tell him what you did 14 years ago.
That was another time.
Makes excuses, displaces blame, does a great many things, in fact, except take responsibility!
No! Who did what and why must wait?
No.
You and I are finished.
Son.
Do you think me so soft that by calling me son, I might change my mind?
Don't think I have any intention of caressing your cheek and saying I was wrong. Still, I'm proud of you in a way.
Do you regret anything, Desmond? What's it like spending your whole life avoiding hard decisions?
Is Desmond worth all this trouble? You know, what is he? Is he the chosen one? Is that it? Little Jimmy special? Some bollocks like that?
I wish I'd been more patient with my parents. I wish I'd listened.
Thank you.
For what?
For making sense.